Indeed, Scott on Radio, welcome back to the other side of the show here right now. Of course, the crucial side that you've been waiting for the last couple of days here. As we promised, we'd say we have Coxon and also Quaker City in the house to talk about Sir Christopher, a tribute to Sir Christopher last night and at the Dominican, and my people dance full. Big up everybody who turned out for that event. Enough manners and respect. Oh, you mean every single time? We're going to try and hook up with, of course, we were trying to hook up with Coxon, but his phone still turned off. And I can understand he's probably tired and all sort of stuff, but I hope he can come in at some later point before 2 o'clock. But we're going to knock the door of the man himself, Quaker City, who's up already and ready to go to talk to you about his friendship with Sir Christopher. And the times they spent together. I know for a fact he's got a lot to say as well. So we're going to... Yeah, man. This tune, a big tune, you know. Okay, we're gonna make that call for Quaker City. We're gonna go for Quaker City for the first part of the interview. Tribute for Sir Christopher last night. We're gonna talk to him right now. Yeah, man.
Yes, sir. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Quaker. Good afternoon, sir. Thank you for being with us after a sort of an excited night last night as we paid tribute to Sir Christopher. Thank you for being here this afternoon. Your time around with Sound System has been documented with many different people. Tell us about the first time you heard of Sir Christopher and where did you hear that name?
You mean when he come out with Sound System?
Yes.
Well, the first time I know of him is when he take over the sound from a man who was in Birmingham named Duke Sonny. And when he take the sound over and put it on the road, then we play for a guy that have a club over in Moseley named Johnny Johnson at Stony Lane.
Okay.
And that was in 73, around that time.
Around that time. So the sound itself came originally from my brother from Birmingham in the first place. And obviously,
yeah, that sound was belongs to Duke Sonny.
Okay.
One of the top sound, one of the leading sound in Birmingham in the 60s.
All right. Okay.
So, and then Sonny sell it over to Sir Christopher. And along with Sir Christopher, coming from Sonny's stable, you have Shanty, Linford, Berger, Cannon, and Dragon, that was Ted.
Okay.
So the posse of guys who was with Duke, so they go over to Sir Christopher.
Okay. So at that point when Christopher bought the sound, Did you know about him before that time, or did you actually know him that time when he bought the sound?
I know him that time when he bought the sound.
So that would have been a news flash to Birmingham that the top sound in Birmingham has sold his sound to a man from Wolverhampton. Because a lot of people are getting it confused between Wolverhampton and Birmingham. And I've had to put some information to the social media that it's not Birmingham, it's Wolverhampton.
Wolverhampton.
Okay. At that point, hearing that news flash that the biggest sound in Birmingham had sold the sound, what was your thoughts about that? And what stage of sound system were you at that time?
When I know about Christopher, when I come out 66 and 2 years after 66, 67, 68, Quaker City start rise very quick. And then we have the few years in the 70s, and then I heard of Sir Christopher.
Mm-hmm.
And when I check it back, he just says that it was Sonny Sound coming out, but his new man taking it over, Christopher.
So we're talking about new management, really?
New management.
Okay. And yeah. And at that time, a splendid sound it was, because when Christopher came back with that sound to Wolverhampton, before my time, it was rocking Wolverhampton to the core. It was an excitement that brought a lot of life to many other sounds in Wolverhampton. In your time, did you ever get a chance to actually play alongside Christopher?
Yeah, man. I remember this very first night when he played against Quaker City. And it was a club named the Roaring 20 in Stony Lane, Smalley.
Okay.
Sorry, not Smalley, Mousley. And in the dance tonight, I just leave Legs the Giant in West Bromwich, who was an amplifier builder, and went to London to have my sound built, to step up, to have a bigger sound.
Okay.
And I playing in this club, and Johnny says, anyway, that me and Sir Christopher gonna play it. So that time Christopher just come out. I think me was the first man in play a song against. So anyway, this night we string up in the sound, and we was at the time we was at the top of our game, and I see the song coming, and I have to laugh before he even put a record on. The vibes that the guys are giving is they're saying that our sound a joke sound, and this is a better sound, and they didn't hear their sound.
Okay.
And you cannot make a competition in that way. You have to hear your things first. You don't show if you're gonna play.
Okay. Okay.
Anyway, I stood there, and they're stringing up, and we playing a tune. I never forget we playing an upset rhythm named Waterman, and I see this tall figure walking across, and I know the figure was Lloyd coxsone from London, and this Sir Christopher. I didn't know him to talk to. And they walk over, and Lloyd coxsone says to me, says, use your own, I say, yeah. I says, is Mr. Harold build this equipment? And I say, yes. And he looked at Christopher, and he shake his head, and he said, we are good friends, you know, Chris. But it's going to be a problem, you know.
Okay.
And the two of them walk back.
So who told who was going to be a problem? You're going to have a problem, or Chris was going to have a problem?
Coxsone told Chris that he's going to have a problem.
Okay.
He's going to have a problem because they sound like they could not play Quaker City at the time.
At the time. Okay, but at the time when Christopher bought the sound, how long did it take before he actually came out with the sound to play it against you, from the time he bought it, or from the time you first heard that information?
No, from the time they bought the sound, they come around, and it was a hype. They did not do the fear to them. They did not do their homework properly, because they did take it on a different level, because the sound was not a big sound. It was mostly a blues sound.
Okay,
all right. Play at all, but
okay.
Small venue.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, that night after we played in the club, he walks over to me, that time Lloyd leave and gone back to London. And he walks over to me and he says, "Nice sound, brother.
Mm-hmm.
Let's have a drink." And from that day, we bond.
Okay.
We bond tight.
Right. So, you know, over that time, how did the dance go that for the first time with you and Christopher?
It wasn't successful when they say Ramo dance, but it was a nice turnout of people.
Okay. First dance. First dance.
Yeah.
Well, of course, the friendship that you had created alongside with Christopher is unique, and many people, you know, in terms of people coming to dances, etc., never hear the other side of the sound system fraternities like the giants of your kind, like, for instance, Shaka, obviously, Christopher, Coxon and yourself, the Killing Machines back in the 60s, coming from that time, making the entertainment the best it could be at that time, regardless of the situation, in terms of Windrush and the people from different parts of the Caribbean and able to enjoy themselves. You know, for you as a keen brother, close to home for Christopher, how did you get on with him as a friend, as a good friend? For the people in tune this afternoon here, right, I'm talking to Quaker City. We played tribute last night for Sir Christopher last night. And many people from around the world are in tune here right now. So we've been trying to get contact with Sir Coxon. At the moment, we don't get any reply. But we have Quaker City Karl here right now, talking on behalf of the South System Fraternity, on behalf of the Morgan family, and talking about Sir Christopher. So tell us a bit more about Sir Christopher and what was your relationship like with him?
Well, I was blessed to have a man like Christopher as a very true friend. Because he's a special. He was put on this planet as a special person with the love what he have for people and the charisma of gentleness with people, you know. There's nothing too good you ask Christos and him don't try to help you out. He's always there for you. Don't care who you are. Don't care if you are suffering and you say something to Chris Morgan. He is very weak when it comes to that. He's ready for help. Ready for help. And admire him for that, you know.
Okay. Okay. He was well loved throughout Wolverhampton and the whole of England.
I was going to say the whole world will know him.
Yeah. And I'm sure there's a lot of pictures and et cetera will be flying around for the next duration of a good time in terms of the event of last night. Last night itself, let's go to last night. Last night was a tremendous turnout.
Yes, I feel proud and to see what Christopher passed and what he can afford to still do. I'm going to do many more.
You know, in terms of the event last night, I'm saying to the people in tune that it was a full house last night. Tell me, Quaker, when last have you had an event where it has been so full when you've played by yourself? How many years ago was that?
2 years ago. Just after lockdown, the first lockdown, I play in Bedford. Me and Fatman in Bedford.
Just before lockdown?
Yes.
We're talking 2019 then?
Yes.
Right. Okay. What about up this side?
Well, I don't really much play up this side a lot, you know, to be honest.
Right.
Because unless I keep a dance. From years back in the 70s, and I always out of town man playing out, spreading the music world industry,
okay.
And leaving it in the Midland, because in the Midland is a bit of corruptness goes on, and you know, fighting against each other, which we should be loving to each other.
But it was a long time since you've actually been in the Midlands and had an event where so much people was to support you as Quaker City and also for the occasion as well.
Yes, I agree with you. It's a long time we don't have that sort of dance there. But back to it again, the people that come out to the dance is part of Quaker City and Sir Christopher. And it's because of the passing of Sir Christopher, you see so many people out there.
Yes, it was a legendary dance that will not be forgotten for quite some time. And a lot of people that you and I haven't seen for ages came out.
They was there last night.
Yeah, man. And I want to say respect to all of them. I don't know all their names. I know their faces because some of the times I'm shaking hands with people. I forget them name unless they remind me. But handshake is just as good as saying, yeah, man, respect. And even though we've been through some rough times and a lot of people have lost their lives due to COVID and other situations, it was nice to see a number of people in the house last night.
Yes.
How did you, obviously we're trying to get contact with coxsone right now. And of course, we probably left late last night and very tired. He's not a young punkin like he used to be, you know.
No.
But if he doesn't make it today, then we hope to have him up on the platform some other time. But
yeah.
How did you feel all the DJs behaved on the night in terms of tribute to Sir Christopher?
Well, I'm going to tell you this now, but let me just mention this before, a little bit before I go to the DJ. Last night, all I play a Moody's record, but Chris always play. And when we in competition, I would have played a version cut of it.
Okay.
But he didn't have, because I'm collecting music from Moody's before him, they have sound. And when the record play and the crowd asks for it, I take up the version to play when my turn come. And the sadness what come to me when we think of Wilson Green and when we used to play. Honestly, I'm for a big man. I was motionless. I couldn't put it on the turntable.
And this, we're talking about last night. This is what happened.
Last night.
You froze. The word called is you froze. Yeah, you froze last night.
Because it's like I see the man. I could see the dance what we was playing on this on a Saturday night and with the green. And the same atmosphere, a tune come and we would make a reaction to it. And when I take up the tune to put it on the turntable, I froze.
Wow! It's the first time I've heard someone say that. Froze. I tell you something. It's not just you one did have that feeling. Not just froze, but a lot of people's body would have sort of reacted different to the amount of people that was in the place last night. Even myself, when I walked in, I said, "Yo!" Even before I got to the corridor, Mr. Warlander. And when I walked in and looked across to see the amount of people that was in the place last night,
yeah,
a little bit emotional and said, yo.
That's why that was emotional to me. Touched me.
Okay.
You know, now I say that I'm a nice guy, but I'm very rough when you reach certain things. And I said, I don't use no one play upon Quaker City equipment.
Okay.
No, but what? Because of Christopher again.
And the occasion as well.
And the occasion. Mm-hmm. Me have to forget about my rules and give him what necessary. So I don't care if it was a million DJ coming last night. They will have to play. The only thing what I did bar is a laptop.
Okay.
Because I don't want to damage my equipment with laptop. It's not good for my equipment.
Okay. I hear you on that.
But once you bring your CD come and your vinyls, it's all right for me. So I make everybody who come and I says before they start, follow the rules.
Yeah. It was nice to see the DJs rotating in the way they did.
Yes.
And also showing some appreciation and manners. The MCs, I love the MCs, them. Them kind of warm up the place and keep the house in order.
Well, I talked to everybody before them start, and I just said, this is how I wanted it, because you know, it's a lifetime experience, this. Right? And if you play from Quaker City only, to me, you get a privilege. So we want it, privilege go to Sir Christopher. We want it nice.
Right. Is that the first time that you've had so many people playing your sound at one time?
I never have people play for my sound.
No? Yeah, and the reason why I asked that, because previous interviews we've done together, you've discussed the fact that, you know, no one plays on your sound, etc., etc. But the occasion for last night, and time has moved on, life has changed on, equipment have changed, but the love is still the same. You can't change love. Love is always there, the same, and we have to show love for people that have given love to us in them times. For instance, I used the word earlier, no matter what a man may do or a woman may do back in the days to whatever, that's just life. But once they've passed away, all that erases from your mind and straight away is love. And what we saw last night was that word love.
Yes.
And I'm sure that Jackie and Gary, C-Line and the rest of the Morgan family are well proud of the people last night for being there last night. I can see a message here from Jackie, but I can't open it because I'm using the same phone here right now. But at the same time, I'm sure she want to say to me, to tell the people, thank you for your support and the love that you gave towards their father.
Yeah.
And I know for a fact the funeral date hasn't been set up yet.
No.
I tell people right now that some of you who are going to the funeral, regardless of where it may be, half of you or more than half is going to be outside that church.
I would imagine so. I can't tell you that because I'm telling you something. People from Liverpool was there last night. People from Sheffield was there last night. Huddersfield, Manchester, because I don't hear, you know, they come to me as followers what we know. And everybody just come in, and you can see, especially when you play a Moody's record, you can see the sadness come over everybody's face.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I felt that at some stage, and the response just looking on from your sound and looking around. I mean, a lot of people didn't turn up last night, but they've seen some of the pictures and they were saying, "Wow, it's like." But you had to be there to feel the vibes of an occasion that I've never seen that occasion for a sound member of any sound fraternity in Wolverhampton happen in front of my eyes, you know. So I want to say to everybody who was there, big up on yourselves and made the effort, made the time, show the love, and I'm sure there's more love to come from others. And for those who didn't get a chance to come out last night because of situations or were at other places last night, you would have heard the news. It was a full house, everything done. Even the bar staff had to sort of say to people, "We've got no more drinks left." He was like, "Wow." But for the amount, he's not saying he didn't have enough stock. He did have enough stock. But the fact that the amount of people that turned up last night was like, yo, it was mad. Yeah, we want to say thank you to the neighbors for allowing us to use their car park as well.
Yes.
That was a big difference.
That was if the car park wasn't there, I don't know it would happen or they would manage.
Well, I parked further down by the Hickman Park gates that I used to use when I used to play football, and some of the cars was in that area, couldn't get past. It was like it was a total roadblock. People blocking other cars. I don't know why people don't use their common sense. Some people don't have common sense, but blocking people like that just don't care and make it difficult for everybody else. But you know. You got to say shout good night to the people who organized. The security as well played a big part in that as well, you know. Overall it was a splendid night,
you know. From I've been in Hawks to do what I have to do, I have to give it my full 100, you know. I have to give it the full 100.
Well, you sound good, you know.
Did it?
Yeah. Yeah, you know, remember, you have different tunes that have different tempo and volume. So sometimes, if you don't know the tune, then it play a bit low or whatever. But at one stage, me hear the bass line really roll one time, and I say, whoa, you know what I mean?
What I think, as far as the sound side concerned, I listen to a lot of people going around playing record on people's sound. And if it's four or five men playing on one sound, the lead of the sound who playing it, when the other DJ come on to play a record, they don't pull the amplifier the best as though they would play their record. They play the other person records with a dull, dead feeling. And when they put their tune on the turntable, they give it a lot of boost and hype to make it look like you don't have a record to play or you don't sound, you know? But with me now, although I don't do that thing, I believe that everybody should get fair treatment. So every selector who come on and put a record on, I have to give him the full 100% effort.
Right.
To make him record sound good. Because as I tell it to the younger folks, it's not record. Don't tell me about who collects record or who have record in the yard. It's not record, it's sound. If you don't have sound system, you can't make the record sound good.
Mm-hmm.
The record is the least, is the sound. You got to have the sound and apply it at the right time and the right way. Right. You know?
Well, put it this way, talking about sound, obviously there's other sound systems around in England, but we don't see, well, I can't say what I don't see. And that's with me. If I don't see something, we can't talk it. But for what I saw last night, for a sound, an analog sound from that time and from your time, and still playing, it says a lot about you as a person. And to maintain that facilities of quality within the sound, and to sound the way you sounded last night, it tells me a lot that you're very passionate about your sound. The things you've said in the interviews over the last couple of months or so does verify the fact that, of course, Quaker City still has that baseline section from that time. I heard it fire and say, yo, turn that, yo. It was like, yo, can those speakers who have been there for a long time hold that pressure? And it did. So your homework that you've done over the years in creating a sound system that can stand the times of modern times and artificial intelligence can be used to entertain people without any form of qualms or any form of different vibes from anybody.
Godfather, what I try to do, I'm a person, I have to dress properly in every occasion when I'm going out, even when I'm in the house. Now, I have a son, and my belief is that you have to please the people who come out to listen to you. And you as the entertainer, laying it on. I'm going to put it on the best way, like how you dress up and put on your nice clothes and come out. Because I'm going to say, all those people was at that dance last night. Nobody don't go home and wake up this morning with a sore head or a black up ears and all these things, because I don't play those sort of music. I have to play quality to make you enjoy it, you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I hear you.
You see, I don't play sound and when you come out your ears black up and you can't hear anybody and you have to shout on your throat. You can't talk to your mate beside you, your wife or your dancer tune. I don't know them things. You must pump a sound,
yeah.
Nice bass line, nice mid and nice tap, and make the music flow.
Okay. Okay. Right, so let's go back to Sir Christopher. All right, so, you know, Sir Christopher himself, tell him what it was like as a friend to you.
Repeat, please.
Tell us a bit more about Sir Christopher. What was he like to you as a personal friend outside the sound system world?
Well, we sit down and we do a lot of, when we meet up, or sometimes in our callers, me and him say, boy, where there? And we say, so, we'll go have a little drink and we sit down and we talk about life in general, business structure, because I used to run a garage and things. And, you know, music and the sound, you know, all these little things come together.
You must have had some good conversation in terms of other sound system that was around at the time.
And we do.
Was you part of that that Northampton saga every month, once a month at Northampton with yourself? I don't know if you was there alongside Coxsone, Christopher, and also Shaka.
Me and Christopher never played down there, but me and Shaka played around three times. Me and Coxsone played two times. Me and Fatman played down there, but me and Christos never played down there.
Okay. Right.
One of the biggest dance I can remember me and Christos play is Well, I don't know which one is bigger, but you have to punch on it. 70-75, we play at the Birmingham Lock Corner in Earth Street in Birmingham. One Easter bank holiday Monday night. Just the two sound alone, and we have over 3,000 people inside of the hall. And guess what? We only have around 100 black in there. All the rest of the people was European.
Okay.
And then on the next dance was another dance. So we played in Wolverhampton, the Whispering Wheel. We play for a cup. It's a cup dance. We did play me and Sir Christopher.
Hold on. Is that the one down Temple Street at the Roller Joe?
Not Temple Street. This was... Yes. Temple Street, the Roller Joe. You right? Yes, you're right. Barry's night spot was in front of it.
That's right, across the road, yeah. That's right.
That's it. That was a hellfire dance.
Was Christopher part of that dance when you won the competition?
Yes.
When Duke Ali was there as well? King Ali was there?
Yes.
And this is the way you got the tune from Matumbi?
Yes.
From Boris, what's his name? What's his name again?
Baby After Tonight.
Yeah, Baby After Tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And the next record, The Man in Me.
Right. And those tracks came out on the Matumbi album afterwards.
Yes.
Because the cut that you had was a raw cut, unfinished. It was a sample. It was a sample. I get to understand.
Yes, it was.
Okay. All right. Well, Sir Christopher made his name in terms of blues parties. As much as he wasn't that fully qualified for the big dance, but he put his right foot forward and took his knocks like a boxing match. You know what I mean? He was still in the ring.
Yeah, but Chris didn't qualify, you know. Chris didn't have a damn good set to play, and he didn't have the backload of music as well. But what was going on there is that they are man more than man. They are champions and over champion. And it was worked out in the sound region. I did have a better sound than Christy.
Mm-hmm. Well, you had a better sound than most of the sounds in Birmingham at the time.
Well, I did have a better sound than everybody in Birmingham because the same sound of me have playing the preamp and everything at that time sound that way. Same like how you hear sound, you know.
Last night.
Can you imagine?
Yeah.
So it's nothing more to say, you know, about it. But you can have two champions in a one competition. One have to be first and one have to be second.
But still got the same standard at the end of the day. But it only can be one winner.
Exactly.
Okay.
But this is where Christopher come in out. It never interrupt him. Never bother about it.
Okay. He's a man. He's a man that loved his music. I get to understand from his family and so forth. There's many people for me to talk to soon about that.
He's a fanatic.
Yeah, he loved his music. And every time there was a blues party, you could tell when Christopher walked in. Obviously, he always gets his music from Jamaica, hot off the press, and special delivery every single time. And every time he came to blues, he brought his black briefcase. I know, said, boy, some tune, I'm going to play. And that was his time to feature brand new tunes.
Yes.
He didn't play the sound at the beginning. He was always at the end, though. He always came with his briefcase and said, yeah, right now it's on brand new tune, may I play? Yes. And this is where people, his fans, would log in and say, yo, may I have some brand new tune from Christopher. And that's how Christopher got his reward in the industry.
Yeah.
And before that as well, I've heard some stories about London. He tried it in London to be on the circuit for sound and blues. I get to, there's a brother that will be coming on the show soon. He told me the story and I said, wow. And Sir Christopher himself tried to bring in the blues element, but there was other sound system in London that was kicking at the time.
Yeah,
but you know, once you keep trying and keep trying, one day that door will open. That door did open for him, and from that door open, London had total respect for Sir Christopher.
They do.
And also as well, Sir Christopher, he was a stylish man as well.
You can say that again.
I just had a text from coming from his daughter Jackie, and she says to everybody right now. She says, "Hi, Godfather, can you thank everyone for coming last night? For the support was overwhelming and much appreciated. Thanks to you and everybody. Enough love and kindness." That's coming from Jackie and the Morgan family.
Yes.
Absolutely wonderful.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes,
man. Yes. You know, and I wish I could have time to talk to some bigger heads in the place, but everybody was nice, danced nice last night. You know, I mean, I couldn't stay till the end because, you know, I got the show to do, so I got to get organized. But I saw things go. But, you know, it's a wonder that, I don't know, the party hasn't finished yet.
No.
The party not finished yet. And all those who didn't come before are going to come again. And I feel so the after party for that event can only be at the same place.
Well, we hope so. And if they ask me to work, and it makes it even more nicer, you know.
All right. Well, you know, I can't see any other place bigger than that than last night to have a reception like that.
Nowhere else. We have to take we have to have again Paul see what he done as well, you know.
Yeah. And all the staff as well, holding the pressure of the bar.
Everybody.
Yo, the bar was almost feet deep, but they held the pressure. Big up the staff. Man has done respect every time.
Every time.
Every time. I look at free drink next time. But yeah, man, every time. You know what I mean? And everybody else, again, I just want to say thank you. Next time you come, please use the car park.
Yes.
Please use the car park. Don't be ignorant. Don't be rude. Don't try and disable your mind to be in the right place at the right time. Please use the car park and show some consideration for other people, because we have people who are not in a full 100. Some are walking with walking sticks and wheelchairs and etc. Show some appreciation.
Was there last night.
There was, but they came out and they wanted to enjoy themselves. Yes. Big up yourselves. Big up on yourself. You know, I mean, if I start calling people's name, people are going to start complaining that I didn't call Tom, Dick, and Harry. But Tom and Dick and Harry, all right, same way. You know what I mean? So, I don't think I got much to say about that. Anything else you want to say about Sir Christopher and the tribute to the brother? We're still going to have some more to talk. We're still going to bring you back anyway, because the party's not done yet.
I have all the time here for Christopher, you know. He will never get out of my mind until when I go his way as well. When I pass, then that's the time. But once I'm alive, he will be still in the back of my head, you know.
Right. Okay.
Rest in peace, old boy. Him call me short ass, and me call him old boy, you know.
I remember the conversation me and Christopher had one time. And he says to me, "What problem, you know?" I says, "Have we?" I said, "What is it?" He said, "You can't have two Godfathers at ACM town, you know." I said, "Eh?"
Yes, that was it.
So I says to him, Quaker, I says to him, Christopher, listen up. You had the old Godfather, me had the new one. You know what I mean? He said, all right, me go for that. I said, all right, respect.
That is Chris.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Pull me up, every show him say, yeah, me had the old one, me had the new one still, you know what I mean? A different way. Not sound system way, but for radio and presenting. Is my game, and that's where I am right now. That's why I can be able to find time to talk to many people around the world in terms of music, etc. And I want to say shout out to everybody across the waters who's in tune right now. I know for a fact my brethren Irems is in tune right now. Big up all our entourage, people in different parts of the country and the world, America, Canada, Europe, you know. Yeah. So for yourself as well, the name Quaker City is no stranger to the world, because many people who have had good times with Quaker City have left the country and gone elsewhere, but would have known about what happened last night, and still more to come.
Yes, plenty more to come, you know.
Right. So I asked you a question last night. I'm not going to say what it was, but next time, make sure that happens next time.
Yeah. Can you repeat again, please?
I said I asked you one question last night.
Yeah.
And you gave me the answer. I ain't going to tell you what it is. I'm going to leave your mind open, but make sure it don't happen next time.
Okay.
You know what I talk about?
I don't know.
You don't know?
No.
No, I won't tell you. I won't expose you on the radio still, you know.
All right. There's so many things happened last night that some of them don't register yet, you know.
Okay. But in terms of evidence, I'm talking about evidence and stuff, that yeah. The world, that information would have been on the YouTube, and it would have been a big one for the YouTube and for all the people who didn't get a chance to hear or see. But there's enough pictures out there because of the amount of cameras that was around yesterday. People on their phones recording and taking pictures of all kind of different people. There's a lot there to put together so people can see what's been happening.
Yeah, because there was a lady there taking pictures of my sound boxes from Germany, you know.
Wow.
When you string up these canisters, I said, sure, you know, it can go on.
Well, listen, your sound system itself is part of a museum. For real. Because a lot of the youngsters who've never been in that facility were stunned by the fact that a sound could sound that way.
Yeah.
And for the elders as well to know that Quaker can sound that way, the same way too. It's an achievement at your age.
Thank you.
No father son, pack up and gone, you know.
Well, I have to keep it going, you know, do what I can do, because I think I was blessed. I was put here for a purpose in that field, you know.
Well, have to give you started in the right time at the right place and with the right advice.
Yes.
And that's why you are on top of your game. A lot of people use back doors to try and get to the top. You went to the top and got the best information, the best specialists, and this is where you are today because of the groundwork that you put in.
True.
Well, all right. Quaker City, Karl, I want to say thank you for your time.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for your love. And thank the people as well for being out last night. Any last words right now?
I just wanted to the people, and thanks for the time and effort what they make to come out and hear me playing for Sir Christopher. And I hope to do many more of it.
Okay.
In the name of Sir Christopher.
Yeah, man. Well, Quaker, thank you for your time. I know you got things to do right now, so take it easy.
I'm going to go and load up the truck now.
Yeah, and I'll speak to you soon. Well, a little later on, actually. But yeah, big up yourself, Sylvia. And big up your sound crew as well for those guys working late last night. Yeah?
Thank you.
Okay. Manners and respect to yourself.
Listen.
All right. A little more. All right. Skylineradio.org.uk. There you have it. The sounds of the voice of man called, of course, Quaker City, talking on behalf of last night and for the Morgan family. I know for a fact a lot of you have been, you know, patiently waiting for this interview to happen. And, yeah, man, the celebration of life for a man that was well-loved amongst the sound system fraternity. That name itself will still ring for a long time, Sir Christopher, just like, of course, the man himself, Shaka Son as well. Yeah, I forgot that. Yeah, Shaka. So, yeah, man. So, a lot of stories still out there to come. A lot of stories to come. And other people to come on the platform as well. Because I think a lot of people are now realizing that time is short for everyone. And we're not going to be here forever. And they may want to tell their story about their sound system as well. And look out for that to come. Don't forget, next week, Sunday. Oh, we have next week, Sunday.
We
got a couple of minutes to do a few things here. Who we have next week? Who we have?
Hi, this is Mr. Swing Easy, the Revival Doctor. And off the back of my recent session with Skippy and Lippy in West Bromwich, you can find out more about me when I meet the Godfather on his Keep It Real show, Vinyl Sunday, Sunday the 28th of January, 1 p.m. UK time on Skyline Radio. Mr. Swing Easy, the Revival Doctor.
Well, all right. Swing Easy next week, Sunday. Talk to the Godfather. Another topper interview right now. Now, for those who are waiting for Coxon's phone is still turned off, I'm afraid. I can only send my apologies to you right now. I know you want to hear from the king himself. Yeah, man. The big man himself. But obviously, he's not a young spring chicken like we are. And probably he's tired. And sometimes things do happen where, you know, but at some point, we'll get that conversation from Coxon himself, because I know for a fact he has a lot to say about Sir Christopher. And for the time that he spent in Wolverhampton back in them days, remember, you know, Coxon did spend 6 months in Wolverhampton in a club 67. And I tell you, he must have some stories to tell. I made contact with Blacker Dread. If Blacker Dread's out there, pick up yourself, sir. You know, the days of Blacker Dread when he started his time in Sound System from Wolverhampton. I tell you. Well, all right. Scannerradio.org.uk. A couple more minutes to go from me. Like I said, my apologies. No coxswain. Probably lay up in that bed. We can't understand at his age. Yeah, man. Oh, yeah, man. But we're going to get him up here. Don't worry about that. Trust me. I'll get him up here. In the meantime, between time, lively up on yourself.
The weekend sounds great.
That Vardy is the man.
Music. I tell you. Listening pleasure. I don't know if I came late last night, but I didn't hear any Bob Marley tunes when I came, and I didn't hear no Gregory Isaacs neither. Say shout out to all the people on my WhatsApp. Big up on herself, man. Loving her like cooked food. I tell you. Actually, so much people mentioned last night. Enough. Last night I was approached by the brother from the Annex Bar. He said, yo, Godfather, enough respect. I said, respect, brother. Like I said to Quaker, party don't finish yet for Christopher. Still got the biggest event to come, the funeral itself. My people, prepare yourself to be outside the church, whichever church it may be. I wanna be lively myself, y'all. And whichever part the after party is gonna be, my people, make sure you carry a lunchbox, you know. Yeah, man. Final Sunday next week, you know. Oh, yeah, mean?
Bongo man, them go to the car. Which part? The man never got a church into the park, but I've got the pong there. Big gosh!
So join me next week, Sunday. We have another topper interview next week. Tell your friends. Skyline Radio is the place to be on a Sunday, 11 o'clock till 2, with the full Sunday team. It's Vinyl Sunday next week, Sunday. Myself, Valentino, Mr. Fix, up until the hours of late in the nighttime, I tell you. No matter what tunes played last night, there was enough respect to everybody. I tell you, I had a wicked time. Shout out to the ladies. I tell you. All looking good last night. And wherever you went last night, I hope you all had a good time. I tell you. Once again, my apologies for no coxswain. For Antonov. Oh, you mean, of course, for Antonov and tired. Sure, but next week, he'll be in Birmingham. Next week, Saturday night, and of course, if I said to you I'm going to have him next week, Sunday, probably the same thing as well, so I'm not going to say nothing until I get him on my own, in my own time, and we can do something different from the usual time. Around people? Yeah, alright? Okay.